students. Today, we are going to learn about the introduction of railways in India. So far, we have learned about the different land revenue settlements and how did these land revenue settlements have affected the Indian economy as well as the Indian social system. Now, today we are going to learn about the introduction of railways in India. Introduction of railways. Now, railway in India was introduced by Lord Dalhousie. Lord Dalhousie was the first to introduce the railways in our country, and this was the that is why Lord Dalhousie is also known as the father of Indian railways. Father of Indian railways. Now, Lord Dalhousie, under his guidance, railway was first started. The railway lines were first laid between Bombay and Thane in Maharashtra. And the first railway had started to run in the year 1854. First time the railways had started to run in the year 1854. And we have to now learn about what were the aims or why Lord Dalhousie had introduced the railways in our country. Now, for that reason, let us discuss the reasons. Reasons or aims and objectives of introduction of railways. Now, Lord Dalhousie had given basically due to the reasons that he had given, because he wanted to move the armies, to move army faster to far away places. Secondly, he wanted to increase the British investments in India. Secondly, Lord Dalhousie had wanted to increase the capital, British capital in India. The investment, the British who were investing money, so that money to be increased by the introduction of railways so that they can earn more and more profits. Third, he wanted to build the communication system, to build transportation between ports for the business purpose only, for the development of industries. He He wanted to build the transportation, easy transportation between different ports. So the goods to be transferred from one port to another, or the goods to be transferred from the port to the factories or factories to the ports. So for that reason also the railways were introduced in our country, for the sake of political reason, military reason, as well as the economic reason. Now we will discuss these reasons in detail. Now for the political reason or the administrative reason, so what was the administrative reason that Lord Dalhousie had introduced the railways? Now they are telling the government gave importance on the railways for better communication system. Besides this, the soldiers can be sent quickly to encounter any internal conflicts within the country. So the first one was to move the soldiers or army faster from one place to another in order to remove or stop to any kind of rebellion or revolt against the administration, British administration. For that reason, Dalhousie had introduced the railways. So that will fall under the administrative reason. Secondly, economic reason. Obviously, as I have told, that he wanted to transfer the raw materials in between the mines or the source of the raw material to the factories, and from the factories the finished products to the ports, from where those finished goods could be taken to the different markets. So for that reason the railways was introduced. Besides they wanted to introduce the, he wanted to increase the British investments. As I was telling you that the British capital, the money from the different companies invested in railway, and here we come across a certain term that is known as the guarantee system. Now guarantee system was that guarantee system, what was it? The guarantee system said that the companies invited the companies, the private British companies, private British companies were invited to invest their capital in expansion of railways, for the expansion of railways in India. From 1849 to 1869, and during this period of time a minimum 5% profit was guaranteed to these companies. 5% profit was guaranteed for the investment of money in the expansion of railways in India. So that is why this system came to be known as the guarantee system, because if they invest money for the expansion of the railways in India, they would be getting at least 5% of profit for the investing that much of money. Now these according to this guarantee system, the government will allot the land to these companies free of cost. That means the companies would be having the land from the government, where they were lay the railway tracks, those lines, those lands were given free of cost to them. Secondly, they would receive minimum 5% profit from their investment. Third, the government would buy out the railways after 25 to 50 years. Suppose if the company was for 20 years, the company had laid the railway line in between Kolkata and Sirampur. Suppose Kolkata and Sirampur, a company had laid a railway track. So for 20 years, that company was in charge of everything in this track, running the trains and collecting the ticket amount and everything, maintaining the railway tracks and all. After 20 or 30, 50 years, the government would be buying this stretch of railway track from the company. And the government would be responsible for the development and everything in this particular part of the railway track. So, these companies, this guarantee system, it was a failure. Why? Because these companies started to cheat. They purposely, showed the government about their losses. Even if they were having a lot of profit, but they showed that the companies were having a lot of loss. And from the government, they were getting that amount back. So, in this way, they were cheating the government. And government was losing money. So, we can say that the guarantee system was a failure. The guarantee system was introduced for the development of the railways in India, but ultimately, due to the treachery or cheating of these companies, the guarantee system proved to be a failure for the British government.